county championship title is nearly Durham's after they grabbed the early initiative on the opening day of their match with Nottinghamshire, a team which is being dragged into a real relegation battle. In spite of the 10-15 start at the Emirates Durham International Cricket Ground, Chris Reid decided to have a bat first after calling correctly at the toss, but his side never recovered from the loss of Stephen Mullaney, who was caught by Scott Borthwick in the slips of Chris Rushworth in the game's fourth over. Durham came into this match filled with confidence after bowling Derbyshire out for just 63 last weekend, and Graham Onions was soon amongst the wickets again when Michael Lum gave Phil Mustard a good catch behind. 22 for 2 soon became 39 for 3 when Ricky Vessels was trapped in front by Onions, a bowler in outstanding form right now, as indeed are all of the Durham attack. Rushworth has been at his very best in recent weeks, and he added his second wicket in the next over, as James Taylor was also LBW as he chose the wrong ball to leave alone. Nottinghamshire were in the middle of a horrible collapse. Four balls later, Rushworth had Samit Patel taken behind for a duck, and he was 42 for 6 when Onions dismissed David Hussey in the same manner in the next over, the batsman guilty of a flat-footed drive. Durham was seemingly unstoppable. Notts had chosen to bat because the side who do that first, always Durham, have had a lot of success, even if there hasn't been an abundance of runs scored in the first innings at this ground. That was to be the case again after Reid was bowled by Jamie Harrison's fourth ball, while Usman Arshad didn't need many deliveries himself to get shot of Andre Adams, not a man for a rearguard approach, with Nottinghamshire now on 63 for 8. It was a disastrous position for the visitors to be in. They also knew that a win here would ensure their first division safety, while a draw would have also been very handy for them. Those results were already looking unlikely in spite of a couple of neat glances for four from Luke Fletcher. He was the ninth man to go with a total on 72 as Harrison struck for a second time. Keaton Jennings with the catch in the deep as Fletcher found too much of his bat on another leg side flick. And Nottinghamshire were all out for 78, their lowest ever score against Durham, when Franks edged Harrison to Paul Collingwood. The visitors have been blown away in the first session of the match in only 26 and a half overs. Durham had won their last four championship matches to put them clear at the top of the table, and they must now have fancied of making that 5 from 5 a club record. Yet, after Jennings and Mark Stoneman opened up with a stand of 16, they too started to lose wickets at all too regular intervals. Jennings was the first to go with a nick off Adams to Vessels, the ball almost arriving to him in slow motion, while Stoneman was also held by Vessels in the next over, with his side on 18 for 2. Indeed, Vessels was a busy man in the field as he also caught Will Smith off the excellent Adams, a man who was also enjoying the conditions. Talking of which, the ECB pitch inspector Jack Birkinshaw will decide on Wednesday if this pitch could be considered a poor one. Those at the ground have suggested that the amount of wickets that fell was down to good bowling and indifferent batting. At least Borthwick and Michael Richardson were able to add 20 runs for the fourth wicket. Richardson then edged Adams, now into his 10th over, to Patel on 10. Before the same two combined to remove Ben Stokes for a second ball duck, after he'd driven more than 300 miles to take over from Arshad in the Durham lineup. That made the score 45 for 5, 15 wickets falling in only 48 overs, and Notts would have thought that they were right back in this contest. The big difference was that when Adams came off after 13 overs, the other members of the attack were not able to keep up the pressure. Harry Gurney did have some success with his fourth ball of the match, Borthwick nicking off on a top score of 29 at 74 for 6. But then the game began to change thanks to Collingwood and Mustard, who produced a vital partnership which not only put their side well on top, but may have also persuaded Mr. Birkinshaw that there was absolutely nothing at all wrong with this surface. Indeed, Collingwood suggested later that it was one of the flatter ones used at this ground this summer. Collingwood is a man used to winning four-day games as captain. He came into this match with 13 victories under his belt from 20 games in charge since he took over from Mustard, a man who now delivered the innings which frustrated the visitors no end and put his own side firmly in control. Watchful at first, Mustard began to reel off some excellent shots to show all of those who'd gone before him just how to bat on this pitch. Collingwood, on the other hand, provided the brick wall, which has been a feature of his batting for so many years. This situation was almost perfect for him, and he provided the ideal foil for Mustard as their partnership began to grow into the evening session, the flurry of wickets suddenly a thing of the past. Mustard became the first man of the match to make it to a 50. It was an innings in the context of this day which was worth a whole lot more than that. He'd reached it off 72 balls with 8 fours included, and by the time he'd got there, his side had made it past 150, and a very handy, possibly even match-winning lead was being established. These two Durham legends had added 121 runs in 35 overs for the seventh wicket, when Mustard was finally bowled by Mullaney for an exceptional 77. Mullaney struck again before the close by having Graham Onions caught at mid-off by Fletcher, just after Durham had earned the first batting bonus point of this match. There was only one ball left in this remarkable day, another quite brilliant one for Durham, who will go into the second morning on 207 for 8, with a lead of 129 runs already. And they still have their inspirational captain at the crease on 53, which has been made in just under 3 hours.